So now within iTree Canopy, we've defined our municipal boundaries of Worcester, Massachusetts, a sample city that I've just created using the shape tool, which we find right up here. That shape tool then allows us to add the boundaries of the municipal boundaries or whatever the geographic area of a defined project area would be. Once we've completed that step, we go down here to the Finish button and simply click Finish, where we'll go to step two in our project. In step two, we can actually check on anywhere we are within the project by clicking on the question mark, and it will tell us. Step two, iTree Canopy allows us to enter a variety of cover classes to survey across a study area. The default is simply a non-tree tree set of classes, but we may edit, add classes as desired, which I'll demonstrate to you right now. So in this case here, we just click configure the cover classes for the survey, and our default of tree and non-tree will show up. So at this point, we're able to decide, or we could have predetermined, what the canopy class areas that we're going to use for our urban tree canopy study. And so in this case here, I know I want to use tree, but my non-tree, I want to change that. So I just simply highlight that row, and I click on the Edit button, and I'm going to change non-tree here to ground cover. And I'm going to change the class to GC. And then over here, I'm going to call that ground cover areas. And then I just hit Submit. Okay, so now I have my cover class as ground cover, and it's defined with the abbreviation of GC, and it's ground cover areas. But let's add another area here, and we're going to call this one shrub. So what I do is I just highlight this, or excuse me, let's do this. We're going to add a new one by clicking the plus button, and I'm going to add shrub. And my abbreviation for that is going to be SH, and we're going to call this shrubs and bushes. We're going to click submit. So now we have that third area. So we have tree, ground cover, and shrub. And let's go and add another one here. We're going to call this, I keep making a mistake, and it just shows you how easy this is to use, because you can simply go and go back, and we're going to edit. But in this case here, I'm going to add a new one. So let's add this new one, and we're going to call this impervious areas. And we're going to call that IMP. And a description will just be impervious areas. And we hit submit. So now we have all of these areas, and we could also, because I saw a river there that comes through, or a lake, we could go and we can add one for water. And so we just type in the word water. The abbreviation for that could be water, whatever you want to use, and then water. And we're going to go to submit. So now I've configured all of our survey area with these classes of cover: tree, ground cover, shrub, impervious, and water. And then I simply click over here where it says done, and it takes me to step number three, where we begin the canopy survey. Okay, so why don't we do that and let's get started. And so we simply now can begin our canopy survey with the clearly defined areas.